Okay, so item number one, the same content creator who took down Alex Jones with his Alex Jones deception video has recently made a similar video on Jimmy Dore, who at this point is pretty much catering to the same crowd. Tracking Jimmy Dore's evolution from merely being the most annoying and least informed member of the Young Turks, to a passive-aggressive and cowardly version of Alex Jones, this is a must-watch. I have included a link to the video in the description. Of course, if you're watching this video, chances are, you've already watched or are at least aware of that video. So I'll pivot to a related topic. A few weeks back I pointed out that the low information left repeatedly parrots the notion that Jimmy Dore is growing like gangbusters and he's doing so at the expense of other channels like TYT. Yet the metrics show that Dore's show, in addition to having a smaller sub count than most of those shows, and in many instances, a much smaller sub count, receives only a portion of the video views. And that in fact, smaller channels like Vosh and Destiny were receiving similar views per month. Well, fast forward a few weeks and the Doorknob show has continued to fall in terms of video views, and sure enough, Destiny and Vosh are both outpacing Jimmy Dore in terms of monthly video views. Keep in mind, Vosh was a 19,000 subscriber channel 2 years ago, and he didn't get a head start by springboarding from the Young Turks. He has now surpassed Jimmy Dore, the imminent threat that the infamous they, whoever they are, don't know what to do with.
Me, and they don't know what to do with me because, again, all the usual, they have Wikipedia putting smears on me that I can't get rid of, CNN's.
The point is, the Jimmy Dore grift is fading. We already know a sizable portion of his viewers are right-wingers, tuning in to watch him bash the same people as Steven Crowder, Ben Shapiro, and Candace Owens, as Jimmy never challenges right-wing viewpoints and tiptoes around criticizing Republicans. As for the poor dupes on the left who still fall for this grift, those viewers are being cannibalized by the low IQ anon channels like Jackson Hinkle, Hard Lens Media, and the insanely boring socialist MMA. The point, this loud minority of people on the left that makes the overall left look bad isn't growing and, if anything, appears to be dwindling at this point. Now I know what the Doorknobs are thinking, sure EPU, but look at the views for a single video and or the alleged live streams that are totally not pre-recorded. Sure, the following that Jimmy has is more dedicated. Whether it's the true believers, however many still exist, or the right-wingers watching him for entertainment purposes, they tune in large numbers. But here's the thing, look at the prep time it takes for a single Jimmy Dore show, where he vomits his rehearsed monologue for 30 minutes over a tweet he disagrees with, and a tweet that supposedly refutes the tweet and ignores the umpteen tweets that refuted the tweet he's drooling over, all while his wife forces herself to laugh at his unfunny commentary. In that amount of time, Destiny and Vosh, neither of whom have shaved since 2015, will have pumped out several, random, stream-of-consciousness videos while they play Justice League or Resident Evil 9000, or whatever it is that they happen to play at any given time. I know Dorons like to claim that Dore is bringing right-wingers to the left, but I see no evidence of this, any more than was the case with people like Dave Rubin and Tim Pool. The comment sections clearly show this isn't the case. The only agreements the left has with Tucker are meaningless and already existed before Jimmy ever went onto his show to entertain his crowd by bashing progressives and Democrats. Whining about corporations is something even Bill O'Reilly was doing a decade ago, and cheerleading for Julian Assange is something which the right has been doing ever since it became clear that Assange's role is to only leak information that's detrimental to the Democrats. I don't see Tucker agreeing on single payer, an increased minimum wage, or stronger unionization. And Jimmy isn't refuting any of the right-wing attacks on these positions, so the right-wingers tuning in to him are enjoying watching him bash the most progressive people in Congress while he never bothers to challenge right-wing policies and tiptoes around criticizing Republicans. Contrast this to real left-wing content creators who actually debunk right-wing propaganda. Functionally, Jimmy Dore is about as left-wing as Tim Pool. It's obvious that his growth at this point depends on right-wingers. Jimmy's subscriptions have been tanking month over month and only saw a spike last month when he appeared on the Tucker Carlson and Joe Rogan shows. Nevertheless, his video views continue to taper off. As for the people claiming that Jimmy Dore is fighting for the common man or whatever, no, he's making money. If yelling into a microphone is fighting, then any one of these content creators can be considered a fighter. This is why it's important to point out the fact that Jimmy Dore lives in a $2 million home. Not that being a 55-year-old man having a $2 million home in Los Angeles makes Jimmy an out-of-touch oligarch. but doorknobs pretend that Jimmy is the equivalent of a doctor who sacrificed a lucrative career to instead work for Doctors Without Borders, or a hotshot lawyer who opted to work as a civil rights attorney in an underserved community, for a fraction of what they could have otherwise made. Nope, Jimmy is doing the best he can with the skill set that he has. Oh, one other stupid excuse I'd like to address. I keep hearing that it's not about left versus right, it's about those at the bottom versus those at the top, or the working class versus the elites, or some variation of this. Fair enough, but the actual policies that people like Tucker Carlson are espousing favor the elites and hurt the poor. Jimmy Dore is providing a platform for a white nationalist crowd whose idea of populism amounts to tax cuts for the wealthy, union busting, deregulation, and anti-immigration if not outright xenophobia. In other words, populism in name only. And Jimmy does nothing to educate these people. He just bashes the very people they love to hate. That's why it's a good thing that the Jimmy Dore show is tanking, at least in terms of influence. I'm sure he's doing great financially and has some very generous donations from conservative oligarchs. My question is, how long until we see him in a PragerU video? We'll be right back.